Today, world-renowned Oaxacan traditional cook Abigail invites me to her restaurant to teach me how to ground corn with a Prehispanic metate. We're making a mole that was being eaten by the Zapotecan people before the arrival of Columbus. This ancient mole is so delicious that it will put a smile on your face and take you back in time to meet the roots of pre-Hispanic Mexican cuisine. First of all, let me just say that getting to film with Abigail Mendoza is kind of a big deal. An expert in traditional Zapotecan cuisine, Abigail has traveled to Paris, San Sebastian, and other culinary capitals to teach classes. Now, it's Peru and Japan that are inviting her to come do workshops. Look, even celebrity chef Anthony Bourdain knows to stop into her restaurant. Needless to say, I felt pretty honored to be able to spend a morning with this legend of Oaxacan cuisine. Her restaurant, Tlamanali, is named after the Zapotecan god of the kitchen, and inside you'll find all sorts of vibrant details. She showed me some of the seasonal local herbs that lend their distinct flavors to comida Zapoteca.
Tiene un sabor muy penetrante,
sí.
Pero muy rico.
Sí, voy a llevar uno para los Estados Unidos. Mis maletas, ojalá que no me ponen en problemas.
Ándale. Y los chiles.
Si todo mi canal de YouTube no funciona, yo voy a empezar a cultivar los chiles, ¿ok?
In order to make an authentic pre-Hispanic mole, you'll need a pre-Hispanic grinding stone, a metate. The metate grinding stone, like corn itself, is an essential part of Mexican culture. It is one of the oldest domestic tools in the Americas, as old as the domestication of corn itself, dating back all the way to 7000 BC. It is estimated that the women of ancient Mexico spent 30% of their waking life milling corn on the metate. In fact, when an Aztec family gave birth to a baby girl, her umbilical cord was always buried under the metate, in the heart of the home. When it comes to teaching metate technique, Abigail is one of Mexico's most respected instructors. If you're in Oaxaca, you can take one of her classes on pre-Hispanic cooking techniques. At her restaurant, she has 6 different metates, but at home, she has over a dozen. She uses a different metate for each traditional ingredient.
¿Por qué el metate es tan importante para la gente zapoteca?
Porque aquí adquieres, obtienes todo el sabor tal cual es del ingrediente. Porque esto es manual y se respeta los sabores. En cambio, cuando es una máquina, las vueltas que da queman los sabores.
Y veo que tú tienes varias metates aquí. ¿Por qué hay 5 o 6 aquí?
Porque es muy importante. Por decir esto, es puedo usarlo para el maíz seco y maíz tierno. Y el otro es para chocolate. Para pasta de chocolate, esto. Y este es para chile, y este es para sal de chile, y el otro es para hierbas. Entonces eso es muy importante también para la cocina zapoteca, porque así respetas los sabores.
¿Qué sientes cuando usas este metate prehispánico?
Y cuando usamos el metate prehispánico, pues siento que estoy con mis ancestros, con mis abuelos, con la gente que ha vivido antes y está siempre presente conmigo y sigue vivo la raíz.
¿Y poder aprender a usar un metate?
Para aprender a hacer un metate es toda tu vida.
Oh.
¿Por qué? Porque ahí es tú para poder agarrar la mano así, necesitas tener una práctica que lo tienes que aprender. Yo lo aprendí desde los 5 años. Si quieres aprender un año, 2 años, ya puedes manejar un metate.
1 o 2 años, ya. Bien, pues más tiempo que había pensado, pero me gusta escuchar esto.
Ella,
es difícil físicamente moler mucho, pero para ti, ¿es trabajo o es placer?
Para mí es placer. Sí es trabajo, cuando ya tú haces un almum, unos 20 kilos de maíz.
Si yo hiciera 20 kilos, voy a pasar el resto de mi vida en esta posición. Hola, ¿cómo están? Yo ando por aquí.
All right, let's get into the kitchen and start making this pre-Hispanic mole. You'll need corn, fresh, ripe tomatoes, dried chile chicotle peppers, and fresh yerba santa. The first step is to toast the corn on the comal. Keep it moving around a bit or it will burn. It will start to pop when it's ready. Next, take the seeds out of the chile peppers, which are actually a species native to Oaxaca. Then you'll soak the chiles in water so they'll be more tender for milling on the metate. First, she milled the corn. I'd be willing to bet that in pre-Hispanic Mexico, every recipe had corn in it. They even mixed corn and drank it with their chocolate. Corn made up for 80% of the calories in the pre-Hispanic diet. Step 2 on the metate is to ground the chicotle peppers into a potent red chile paste that will mix into our mole. Now, stir the toasted ground corn into the same water that you used to boil a chicken. That chicken broth is going to make this mole extra delicious. Then, you'll mix in that pepper paste and give this mole its signature red color. Finally, add some yerba santa to lend a peppery, slightly minty taste that is refreshing contrast to the other flavors. Ta-da! Thousands of years after it was invented, this ancient mole still pleases the taste buds. Thank you so much, Abigail, for sharing your heritage, your expertise, and your smile. This pre-Hispanic mole is one for the books. Reporting in from Teotitlan, Oaxaca, I'm your host, Eric Kenneth.